this time, we'd like to welcome you to Cornerstone Baptist Church. Thank you for attending for tonight. At this time, we'll start off with a video presentation, and then the evening will commence.
The word gospel translates to news that brings joy. But this isn't just any news. A gospel is news that changes a life forever. After being invaded and enslaved by Persia, Greece won two decisive battles at Marathon and Solonus. The Greeks sent out heralds, also called evangelists, to proclaim the good news to the cities. We have fought for you. We have won. And now you're no longer slaves. You're free. The reality is that we are all slaves, slaves to sin and slaves to death. We are slaves in need of good news. Enter Jesus, God's Son, fully God, fully man, bringing news that would change our lives forever. His news was this: I am the divine, come to you to do what you could not do for yourself. I will take what you deserve so you can have what I deserve. You have no idea how much it will cost me, but you also cannot imagine the depths of my love for you. It is a gift that I give freely. So repent. Repent from all the ways you've run from me and follow me. Follow me because I am the only way to eternal life. Follow me because I'm the Savior you've been looking for. Follow me because I have authority over everything, yet I have humbled myself for you. Follow me because I died on a cross for you, because I'm your true love and your true life. This is my good news for you. This is my gospel. That you have been saved by grace, and that you are slaves no more.
And that is the power of the gospel. That's grace. This Easter time of year, let's not forget the reason that makes this day a point of paramount significance, and that's grace. Not just grace, but marvelous, infinite, and matchless grace. God showed his unmerited favor and love to each and every one of us. Grace is the love and mercy given to us by God because he desires us to have it. It's not because of anything we have done to earn it, and we know that. We know that there's nothing good enough we can do to earn this amazing grace. Religious trends strive to work to make good deeds outweigh their bad deeds. But this, my friend, this is not grace. We understand that. This is works. This is righteousness in our eyes. But compared to the eyes of heaven, they're nothing more than filthy rags. At the end of the day, we know that there is no way we can succeed in becoming good enough. The Bible states that all have sinned. Lying, stealing, cheating, sin is sin. Because of this sin, we will always fall short of God's glory. But we have a good God, don't we? When we verbally confess, when we call on the name of the Lord, when we believe in our heart that God raised Jesus from the dead, the Bible says we shall be saved. And he is risen and Christ is risen. That is what Easter is about at this time. We'll have the beginning of our cantata. The choir is ready to go, and I hope that you are excited about this. And please enjoy.
Sing it out with joy.
Amazing grace and amazing love. That's amazing. Quick poem by Carrie Schmidt. As we understand about grace, understand where God comes from with that love for us. We don't deserve it, but as I said, listen to this quick poem from Carrie Schmidt. In God's heart, there's a place that we were made to fill. We can find his amazing grace when we're found within his will. And in our heart, there's a place that only God, our great God, can fill. He covers our disgrace with the blood that Jesus spilled. And he's reserved a sacred place where we can spend each day. And he's waiting there for us, inviting us to stay. Every day, be amazed that God would spend the day with you. Be overwhelmed by his ways that he could feel such love for you. To him, we are worth saving. And our hearts should be craving to know him in his righteousness and understand his ways. Every day, in every way, be amazed. At this time, we'll have another group come up and sing Because of Grace.
Because of sin. he looked at Christ and said, when your kingdom comes, remember me. In paradise that day he stood, just like the Lord had said he would, surrounded by those who had gone before. One said, friend, how did you come? What are the deeds you have done? With tears in his eyes, I can hear.
Tonight, just the idea of grace, that the amazing grace, the amazing love, the grace that we heard tonight, just reminding us that God loves us unconditionally, no matter what we do, no matter what we say, no matter, you know, as I teach my kids, one of our favorite verses, it seems like it's, and be ye kind, and just simple things like that, and be ye kind. Christian, to put a smile on your face, to be that difference, to show God's grace, definitely, to pick up a tract, to share that grace, As we live that grace each and every day, I do hope that that is a great reminder. Easter is next week, and just the reminder that Jesus is alive. He did raise from the grave 3 days after he had died. And we have that living Savior, that awesome Savior, that Savior that gives us that grace. At this time, we are going to have a time of invitation, a time of thought. Just if you need to speak with the Lord, if he had spoken to you tonight as we stand, and if you want to sing with us, it's 202. So take your hymnals, stand with us as we do that. If the Lord has spoken to you tonight, 202, amazing grace, amazing grace, his grace for us tonight. As we stand and sing, if this is a time for you to come, speak to the Lord if he's spoken to you. Amazing grace. On that last. Pastor with announcement, offering, and then we also have a baptism tonight, so please be aware of that.
Amen. Thank you, choir, orchestra, sound people, instrumentalists, and you and I for listening, because we were blessed. Amen. All right, now I turn it back on. Hey, I learned how to do that. How many years did it take? Long time. All right. Anyway, a couple announcements. But while we're making those announcements, those who plan to be baptized, if you'll go ahead and go and prepare, we'll be ready for that in just a few moments. Want to remind you that next Sunday is Easter Sunday. So that means 7 o'clock, we have sunrise service. And I encourage you to come be part of that. We never have failed yet, so we should be able to make it to have everybody out by 7:30, or at least my part done by 7:30. If you stand and talk, that's up to you. But we should get done in time for you to be able to go have breakfast, come back, and be part of the morning Bible classes and morning service. So next Sunday's a great day. We always look forward to that. Also, back on the table outside in the foyer are some family photo sessions brochures. This is a project of a senior class for their senior trip, and there's information about that. They're going to be taking those coming up in April. I think the 8th and the, don't have my glasses, 9th, is that correct? Okay. And so if you're interested in that, it's $30 for the package of CD that has 10 to 15 professionally edited pictures, be done over in Fort Harrison. So if you're interested in that, pick those up, and certainly they will be glad to accommodate you with that. All right, and then it's Baptist Church, and yes. Okay, the sign-up sheet for times there, Friday night, Saturday morning. So mark that on your notes also. Then 2 weeks from tonight, following the service, we have a reception, housewarming reception for our new youth pastor and his wife, and I want you to come be part of that. And it's kind of a pitch-in dinner, so if you would sign up on the bulletin board by the nursery to bring whatever you would like to participate with, that would be to help. We just want to be an encouragement to them, and that gives you an opportunity to do so. I think this time we'll go ahead and receive our tithes and offerings, gifts to the Lord. As we look to the Lord in prayer, Brother Bob Harrington, would you lead us, please? Amen. All right. Well, thank you again for being present tonight. I trust that you have been blessed as I have. And we encourage you, of course, to be in thought for next Sunday services. Let's stand and be dismissed in prayer. Brother Steve DeWitt, come on up here and dismiss us in prayer, would you please?
Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for this evening where we can just get together, Lord, and reflect on what you have done, Lord. And I just hope that this was honorable to you, Lord. Thank you for all the work that was put in. And I just pray this week it's something we continue to reflect on, Lord, and that we can just show it in our lives, our thankfulness for you, Lord. Just be with us as we're all going about our separate ways this week. Keep us safe and help us all to return Sunday morning. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.